students, how are you? This is Roger once again, pleased to meet you. Students, last week we discussed about the formation of tenses. How many tenses are there? Today, we are going to discuss how to use it, where to use it, when to use it, all these tenses. There are 12 tenses in English. Every tense has its own meaning. You cannot use some, you cannot overlap one tense to another tense. There is a saying in English, walk while you walk, play while you play. You cannot work when you play. You cannot play when you walk. So, you cannot put it there, your present tense in the case of a past tense. You cannot put the past tense in the case of a future tense. So, now our discussion is when to use, where to use, how to use all these 12 tenses. My dear students, let me say, if you have got a very good knowledge of correct usage of tenses, let me underline, when you have the good knowledge of correct usage of tenses, your language will be in the form of characters. That is what we are going to discuss. Okay, don't worry, we shall discuss in very easy, simple way so that everybody can understand. Let me recap what we discussed last week. 12 tenses, okay, simple tenses, simple present, simple past, simple future. More than is, simple tense. Subject, that's present tense of the verb. More than age, simple past tense. Subject, that's past tense of the verb. More than will eat, subject plus future tense of the verb, that is simple future tenses. Then continuous tenses, present continuous, more than is eating, is, comma, are, comma, am, plus verb plus ing, present continuous. More than was eating, was plus eat plus ing, or were plus eat plus ing, verb plus ing. More than will be eating, future continuous, will be plus eat plus ing. Then perfect tenses, more than has eaten, either has or have plus past participle of the verb, that is present perfect. Past perfect, Mohan had eaten, had plus past participle, and Mohan will have eaten, will have plus past participle. Then we have got present perfect continuous, has plus been plus verb plus ing, or have plus verb plus been plus ing. Mohan had been eating, past perfect continuous. Then my dear students, finally, Mohan will have been eating, will have plus been plus verb plus ing. Here I have said the two things that you must not forget in your lifetime. Number one, in the case of simple present tense, when the subject is third person and singular and when the tense is simple present, add yes with the verb. Mohan eats, but I eat. Then in the case of present perfect, when the subject is third person singular, the present perfect form is has eaten. Mohan has eaten, but plural, they have eaten. Right. Now you will know everything regarding the formation, how the tenses are getting formed. Now you are going to see that what I call the usage of tenses. So let us start with the simple tenses. Simple present, present continuous, present perfect, present perfect continuous. My dear students, listen to me. As far as this topic is concerned, I am going to discuss every usage under two different categories. Category number one, the context. Context, when it is used, when a particular tense is used, that is context. And the shorthand method, the clue words. The clue words, when these words are coming, particular tense is there. In the case, I shall borrow the words of Adivelu, Vandutaya, Vandutaya. When these words come, these tenses are there. Number one, context. Number two, clue words. First, simple present tense. What is the context? Universal truth. What are the universal truth? The sun rises in the east. We don't say the sun will rise in the east tomorrow. We don't say the sun rose yesterday in the east. These are all universal truth. For that universal truth, simple present tense. Example, the sun rises. One more example, water boys. I can give innumerable examples, but time not sufficient, they will be cut short. Then habitual and recurrent action. Habitual. I get up early in the morning, every day. It is true or false, huh? During the corona days, are you getting up early? But let us assume, I get up early in the morning, usual habit.
Usual habit, simple present. Recurrent, the bus comes every day here. The bus comes every day here. The action that is happening every day for the view who simple present. And now the another grammar of the English is sometimes simple present can be used for a future. It is something dialogue. Though simple present also can be used for simple future. For example, my leader comes tomorrow. My leader arrives for lunch tomorrow. Tomorrow is the future. But I can say, my leader arrives tomorrow. My leader arrives tomorrow, maybe future. For that, we can use simple present. So, simple present, three contexts. Number one, universal truth. Number two, habitual recurrent action. Number three, future. And finally, let me say, these are all the two words. Usually, rarely, occasionally, seldom, often. Whenever you come across these two words, see that you have to use only simple present tense. Usually, the teacher teaches well in the class. And rarely I go to fill simple present tense. Occasionally, it happens here. Seldom the boy sleeps in the class. Okay? That's all. Simple present tense. Then, present continuous. At the body step, see, context is action at the time of speaking. I am taking the class and you are listening. The action going on at present is I am teaching. You are listening. And number two, see, we can have one more thing also here, my dear students. The present trend. Nowadays, taking YouTube class. Nowadays, we are taking YouTube classes. It has become common. Nowadays, we are taking YouTube classes. That is the present context. That also you can use present continuous. Okay. And so let me say once again, present continuous action at the time of happening. Action at the time of happening. So one more thing we can use. Future tense also. Future. My leader is visiting tomorrow. My leader visits tomorrow. My leader is visiting tomorrow. So let me say for continuous, action going at the time of speaking, action currently happening. Number three, to indicate the future, my leader is visiting tomorrow. So these are all the context under which we can use present continuous and the plural. At the moment, now, at present, at the moment, the bus is going there. At present, the petroleum prices are going up at present. And now, I am watching the movie so seriously. These are all the clue words. Okay, shall I go for the next one? It is present perfect. Present perfect is something different. It is neither past nor present. Neither past nor present. The action that completed in the past still there in the present. The action that completed in the past still there in the present. For example, that is past to present. And there's a very good sensation. You ask somebody whether the train has arrived. Whether the train reached, that is what you ask. Yes, sir, the train has just arrived. The train has just arrived. Arrived, it did not arrive in the past tense. It is not arriving in the present tense. The action sorted in the past, still there in the present. The train has arrived. That is, it is neither past nor present. The thing is, the action started in the past, still there in the present. Okay, what are the true words? Just, yet, not yet. The train has just arrived. They have just completed the work. My friend has just given me his book. Listen, we have not yet finished the portion. We have not yet finished the portion. So these are all the areas where you have to use present perfect. Then past. Then present perfect continuous. So just evaluation. So in the case of present perfect, the action continued in the past, still there in the present. Here, the action started in the past, still there in the present, it will be there in the future also. How it is, for example, if we say, I have been living in Pomaji for the past 10 years. I have been living in Pomaji for the past 10 years. That means 10 years ago, I came there. For the past 10 years, I was living there. Today I am living, tomorrow also I will be here. So far, the action started in the past, still there in the present, it will be there in the future. That is what we have called the present perfect continuous. And how do you know this is and for? Remember these two words, don't forget to memorize. These are all the two words attached with the respective tenses. Okay, since fast, since, listen to me, let me say the difference in the usage of since and far. Since 2010, since 2010, I have been living in Guwahati. That is from the beginning of the year. And for 9 years, I have been living in Guwahati. There is a difference. And here, whenever you come across since and far, you have to use present perfect continuous. Here, let me clarify about the role played by since. Since has got two roles to play. It can be a preposition, it can be a coordinating conjunction. Coordinating, since it is a holiday, nobody is there. That is coordinating conjunction. There you are not supposed to use present perfect continuous. It is a coordinating conjunction. Since it is a holiday, nobody is there. Okay, we understand. But since yesterday, it has been raining. Since yesterday, it has been raining. There, it has come as a preposition. So there is one, my dear students. Hope so you understand. Present universal truth. Have you sure? Recurrent. And indicate your future. Understand? And the two words, usually, rarely, occasionally, seldom, often. Then present continuous, actually at the time of speaking. And to indicate the future also that you can say. At the two words, at the moment, now at the center. Then present perfect from past into present. Just a not at all. And present perfect continuous, past into present into future, since far. That is what, how it is the usage of what I call present, simple present tenses. That is simple present, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous. Hope so, my dear students, you understand these things. All the best. Next, we shall see the next topic. Okay.